follow up on the last report, maybe raised by a single mother. What does that mean? Dad wasn't there, right? Wasn't there. Now my dad stayed probably about 10 minutes away from my mom and I. I saw him how many times you think?
Once a year
I saw my dad. He stayed 10 minutes away. For whatever reason. So all that put together, I didn't stay in the best of neighborhoods. My neighborhood was a rough neighborhood. Now, I was kind of insulated though, because on my street, I had a bunch of older people on my street, and they made sure that the drugs and the crime didn't come on our street. So I was insulated, but all around me, it's nothing but trouble. So all that put together means that I should be a statistic. I should be a statistic. Black, single parent, young, male, I should be a statistic. God. Here I am, not a statistic, but I'm the exception to the rule. I stand here by God's grace as an exception to the statistic. And so, what I want to share with you all today is a couple of principles. I know you all may look at me and look at this suit and say, hey, he looks like a leader. That suit makes him look like a leader. You know what, young ladies and young gentlemen? This suit does not make me a leader. Anybody can put this on. Anybody can put this suit on. So no, the uniform doesn't make me a leader. I'm a leader with or without this uniform. Now, how did I become the leader that I am today? Well, I went through some things. I went through some adversity, some stresses, and some struggles. And it was in that adversity, in those stresses, in those struggles, that I learned to be the leader that I am today. The question is asked, are leaders born or are leaders made? I believe that it's both. Both leaders are born and made. Leaders are born from the womb of a woman, but made in the crucible of crisis. To say it another way, everybody in here is born with the potential to lead, with some capacity to lead. Everybody. But it's only through adversity that that capacity becomes a reality. Only through adversity.